Oh, he had the wood on the Jews, all right. He drove them something unmerciful. How did didn't know what to do, so they cried out under the Lord. Well, in the olden days, the Lord used to mix himself a lot with the people, and he took no end of trouble trying to get it straight again.
Then what made him lose the habits now?
Oh, blokes like you ask a silly bloody question. You see, now the Lord looked around for the foolishest bloke he could find to take on the job of getting these Jews out of their predicament, and the fiery lights on.
Well, it could have been a big noise if he just knew where his fiestas lay.
Well, this Moses goes and marries with a hero. Now, first off, he asks, quite simple like, for all hands to get 3 days' spell and 3 tucker. God's crucifix! What do you think you're coming in? Get back there and tell them children to back here their work a bit louder, or my God, I'll straighten the little buggers up. But the Lord, he backed Moses. And he sent the chlora and the grasshopper and all manner of plagues on the country.
And Tomo.
Some sort of oversight, it appears. Was it for the children by cop that the Pharaoh didn't turn here?
Bald, was he?
Baldness is a phenomenon that appears much later in history, son. Anyway, Moses and the children shot through. And Pharaoh soothes all the hands on the fire. Now, a thing has happened, as no living man would believe without his seed in himself, or read it in his ear Bible. He gets to the Red Sea. The water, she forms apart, and the children, straight through. Pharaoh and the boys try to follow. But the water was... and they was well at. Well, they gets to the land of Canaan's. Moses' spies tell him that the Canaanites and the Rechabites is not sharing.
Hang on, this is a parallel, mate, not sharing. Now, we'd call them the squatters. But I don't follow your reasoning, Simon. You reckon this Moses, he's soft-headed, don't sound like it to me.
Shut your mouth a minute and I'll tell you. Well, one day, Moses up on the mountain doing a bit of business with the Lord, mind. Them Jews is down there, melting down all their jewellery, making this golden calf, and is having a bit of a corroborate. Well, up pops the old Moses. What do you reckon he did?
Grab the calf and off.
Yeah. No, son, no. He seized it like a case of whiskey at the customs, ground it into dust, mixed it with water, and he made him drink it. So it was good boy. I'll do as much as want to get them independent for life. You know, he got worse as he growed older too. He died like some poor old swaggy up on top of a mountain. And there's a fella could have been at the top of his bloody tree if he just stopped for a minute and asked the sleeves.
G'day! Are you on your own?
Yeah, I saw you fly down the track.
I thought you were one of bloody boundary riders.
Jesus, mate! Let's go! Oh, hey! Where'd you hear old Mungle?
Oh, you ended up with the story about those things!
Oh, it's good to see you boys again. How's the feeling?
Oh, help yourself, mate. Have you had any supper?
No, I ran out of target this morning. Thought I'd make room, I got the Reedy River tomorrow.
How you been going, Joe?
Oh, not so bad, I reckon.
Oh, come on, tell us, what have you been doing all these years, Joe?
Oh, well, after I did me stretch. Drove cattle and worked in the sheds up north a bit.
How'd you get down to these parts?
Oh, I took some packs as far as Wilcannia for Johnson and then struck south from there.
And, What have we brought you all the way back, Joe? Is it a job you're after?
Oh, partly. I'll be up at Brady's for the clip.
You said partly, mate. What's the other part? Australia?
Well, you might be right at that.
Well, you got me in, mate. Tell us about it.
And miles down Reedy River, one Sunday afternoon, I rode with Mary Campbell to that broad bright lagoon. We left our horses grazing till shadows climbed the peak, and strolled beneath the shady of summer banks of rocky creek. Then home along the river, that night we rode a race, and the moonlight lent a glory to Mary Campbell's face. I pleaded for my future all through that moonlight cry, until our weary horses drew closer side by side. 10 miles behind crossing on the banks of the river. I cleared the land and cursed it and plowed the rich red wool. And my first crop was gold when I broke Mary home. Now still down Reedy River, the grassy shields are, the water holds still mirror, the pictures in the sky. The golden sand is drifting across the rocky bar, and over all forever goes sun and moon and star.
And what made you break it up, mate?
It's a long story. Mostly my fault, I reckon.
Yeah, well, that's what I wanted to know.
It's a sad story, just would not be bothering the man, Dixon.
Yeah, some of us learned the hard way, I reckon, Irish.
Remind me of this fellow's chances.
Hey, hang on, Tomo. He's not a man young to be out faster.
I seem to remember that name. Mary Campbell.
I knew a Mary once.
Did you use that
name? She was a funny sort, is she?
What's this grey like to work for?
Oh, I've no worse than anyone else, I suppose, Joe. Well, since we lost the strike.
Yeah, boss has kicked the guts out of us.
Yeah, boys took a beating, all right.
Some's are still taking.
Anyone else coming on, Arthur? Seems like a bloke can't find a bit of grass without the whole flaming country jumping all over it.
I saw you firing to them and tick you off. We'll throw this way. This way, we'll get your bullets out of your paddock or you'll be in trouble.
Right.
Come on, digger.
Listen, you're too late, Dunster. Leave the ball for now. Just take it in. Leave it up to me.
It's Friday!
Here, miss, this way. Hello! What the hell are you doing here? Who gave you the right to feed on my ground?
This is a bad job! Best out at all!
You're dead right, Mama. It is a bad job.
The way it came, you see, Mr. Brady, is that we had a bit of loading for Reedy River.
I'm not interested in that. I asked you what you were doing on my property.
That's what I was trying to tell you for. You took the words right out of my mouth. You see, the proper road for us, Mr. Brady, would have been down along the main track to the Malruga Swamp, then back along to the cane grass swamp. But we was a bit pressed, so we just thought we'd cut across on your...
Oh, God, you just thought you'd cut across, eh? Do you own this one?
I don't, Mr. Brady, that's for bloody certain I don't. But if we'd have thought you'd have had any objections now, why, we'd have asked leave.
Yeah, well, that's what you should have done. You've acted like a damn thief.
You'd have given us leave?
I'd have seen you in hell first. No bunch of bullockies is going to make a thoroughfare of my run. I'm going to impound your beast for trespassing on my piece of water.
Right, of course, Mr. Brady, you've got the power to do that, all right?
What is more, that fence has got to be put up right away!
All right, Mother, all right, we ain't never left a man's fence down yet. It's like this, Mr. Brady, I don't deny we've got in here in a sneaking way. I feel it, Mr. Brady, by hell I do. But if we hadn't awarded those bullocks tonight, they'd have dropped in the goat.
What happens to your bullocks doesn't interest me, except when they feed on my property.
Oh, but how would you like to see Barno lying on the ground every time you drove past? I bet you wouldn't have liked that, Mr. Brady.
Good God! The bullocks are going to stand up!
Don't get over. Things that keep coming back, you've got to do something about it.
Things like having a home. And a son.
Those things were ours, Joe. But we lost them.
I'm sorry, Mary. It wasn't until after they busted the strike with Charles that I found out about you losing the baby.
Oh, I'm not holding it against you, Joe. It's just the way everything worked out.
Nah. I didn't do the right thing by you, Mary. I know that now. How's the homestead looking?
It's overgrowing now. 5 years is a long time.
The Reedy Lagoon?
It's as beautiful as ever.
Sweet scent and blossom spreads its glory around, enticing the bird and the bee. As I lay and take rest in a fern-covered nest in the shade of a carrageon tree. High up in the air you can hear the refrain of a woodchipper whistling a tune. And spring in its glory is back once again to the banks of the Reedy River. Oh, where is old Frank, and how could it be right? And Johnny the kind-hearted fool, and Mac the big Scotsman I once heard him say, I wrestle the famous Muldoon. Oh, where is the lady I oftentimes caressed, the girl with the sad dreamy eyes? For I always did care, and I knew you'd stay square on the banks of the Reedy River.
Mary.
We'd better not, Joe.
I thought you might see it differently.
We'd better be getting away from here. Brady might come back.
How do you make it out, Mary?
I'll do all right. I've got a job.
Where you living? Listen, I'll walk you as far as the track. I better help the boys get the bullets out of the can.
Here! Let her mold me, you red-headed red squid! Son of a brandy drink! Here!
Of mates, for years I have camped and toiled and tramped on roads they rough and hilly. I've carried me sensible, indispensable, old Black Billy, my old Black Billy, my old Black Billy. Whether the winds be warm or chilly, I always find when the shadows fall that my old Black Billy's the best mate of all. I've carried me swag on the parched Peru, where the water is scarce and the houses few. On many a track on the great outback, where the heat would drive you silly, I carried me sensible, indispensable, all back to me. My own back to me. My own back to me. Whether the winds be warm or chilly, I always find when the shadows fall that my own black billy's the best mate of all. When at last me trappin' days are over and I drop me swag at the open door, St. Peter will stare when he sees me there, and he'll say, poor wandering Willie, come in with your sensible, indispensable old black billy. My old black billy. My old black billy. Whether the winds be warm or chilly, I always find when the shadows that my old black billy's the best mate of all.
How you doing, huh?
Good day. I enjoyed your song immensely.
Oh, thanks, Mum.
I am the schoolteacher, you know. We're having a social in the schoolhouse next week. You might like to give an item.
No, not me, ma'am. Besides, I'm a sort of dull and stuff. Don't know where I'll be next week.
Oh, do come. There'll be plenty to eat and
drink. What night did you say, ma'am?
Wednesday night at 8.
I'll be there at 7:30.
Righto, mate. You can fill your billy round back.
Oh, good eye. G'day, ma'am.
Good day.
G'day.
A most colourful character. A typical troubadour of our time. It was kind of you to offer him a billy of water.
Oh, well, if I'd offered him a beer, Miss Andrews, he would have been offended. Truly, he would have been.
Why don't you come around to the back, love? I'll get you Rose and the guy.
Oh.
Yeah. of testing. Had we one apple green and the spy, the strength of our protesting. So
cast the mark, fellas, we go and sing. Ring out before we're having a thing. Let's up, ladies, from near and far. Wake up, landlord, and open the bar.
We stopped our free selections with free cattle when we could, just to show there's no appealing. As any would. So,
come on, fellas, we're going to sing. Bring out people, we're having a sing. Dance up, ladies, from near and far. Wake up,
Thank you.
And seeing as how this Philippine hasn't shouted in years, I consider it correct and proper for him to tunnel up.
It'll be a pleasure and a privilege, George. There you go.
Oh, he's a darling boy.
So what's doing in Reedy River, mate? So I can hear you singing down the track.
Oh, we do it, Joe. Cockies are really letting their heads go today, eating, drinking.
For tomorrow they die, or get taken over by the
banks. Well, same thing. Certain fate for Cockies.
All these bush pubs is the same. No brass rails, no elbow room, and no electricity to fall. If you think inside it's so bloody crowded, you're liable to jump your blast into one of them shearers.
Still, Connor, eh? Thank God for Charlie Moss, the man who invented beer. Oh, my God, I wish I could get it. Well, I ain't the good with another identity. Along came a man by the name of Charlie Moss. And he's down in the wonderful river, he's down in the night. Oh, he ought to be an admiral, the Sultan ordered him. And there's praises where he could always sing. A look for being a sufferer, as he killed the sufferer's here. God bless dying off the
men who
live the year.
He knocked on the door. He said to Sir Peter, tell me how I live. Sir Peter looked at him and he said,
now who are you?
Charlie Marks and Peter the Sturge.
Straight through! Oh, he ought to be an admiral of the Sultan already. And to his favours we should always sing. For the funny he has done for us, he's killed us up with fear. And God bless Charlie Marks and Peter the Sturge.
At the currency, that's the old back in the halfway house. And hey, come, when you can be sure it's Charlie's very self. So come along, you lucky lads, and can I go yourself? For my short seconds, remember Charlie Marks.
A one, a two, a three, four, five. Oh, he ought to be an admiral with something ordered. And to his faces we should always sing. A look for he has done for us to fill the cup with cheer. God bless Charlie Marks. And then we get to hear a
tomorrow we work. Sure, it's been many a day since some of us ran a blade over in that
one. Yeah, it's been a while since you said inside the shed, Joe.
Yeah, you've got a few mates there, Bill.
Ah, well, strike's over now. Not much left of the union, though.
Just strike's over. But the fight ain't. We know we must just say this is a lion tamed scoundrel.
Yeah. If we don't watch out, the cockies will be steering us and giving the check to the sheep this season.
Don't worry about that. Things are going to be dropping the sheds by now, Tomo.
Just right you are. And the machine ain't hovering at all.
What, the machine ain't pushed out yet? The scabs will away things are going.
When are you going to use your brain for something else besides keeping the heads apart? And you'll see the machine ain't your enemy.
Yeah, you got a point there, Tomo. But the sheds will have to be organised again.
Yeah. No, Joe, I never had much time for cockies, but I've done. I reckon a man would be better off an acre or two of land.
How about a beer, Nugget?
What's the matter, Bill? Paralysis.
Such of the shots, fellas. Yeah. Someone else will have to swing for the next.
Sharon's a crook life, whichever way you look.
Now, why would you be taking that job? Listen to yourself, let's turn them cocky honest.
You're always on the move, Irish. Your home's a lousy shed. You've never an acre of land to call your own. But you get your check, you live it like a king for a month, and then you hump your blue eagle with wet brakes. Nah, it's no good. Man needs a corner in life to call his own. Yep. Yeah, there's nothing like the feel of a plough and the sweet smell of the earth burning.
And don't be forgetting the sweet smell of the pigs. And the feeding of the little darling. Up to your hocks and muck and all. It's a grand life, all right, for a cocky.
Another bit of Irish's way. Look how many of them cockies got swallowed up when the big boom burst. Didn't have a feather to fly with.
Yeah, nor did we, for that matter.
You're right to know. But it didn't take the heart out of us, like some of the poor devils.
Well, there's many a heart been broken since 1891, Irish. They weren't all cockies.
No. It was a dark and troublesome time.
Now, loosen your purse strings, Tomo. Let's have one to our mates of 91.
Our mates of 91.
Price of wool was falling in 1891. The men who owned the acres thought something must be done. We'll break the shearers' union and show we're masters still. And they'll take the terms we give them, or we'll find the men who will. From Claremont to Barcaldy, the shearers' camps were full. 10,000 blades were ready to strip the greasy wool. When through the west like thunder rang out the union's call, the shares will be sure union, or they won't be sure at all. Oh, Billy Lane was with them, his words were like a flame. The flag of blue above them, they spoke Eureka's name. Tomorrow, said the squatters, you'll find it does not pay. We're bringing up free labourers to get the clip away. Tomorrow, said the shearers, they may not be so keen. We can mount 3,000 horsemen to show them what we mean. Then we'll back the west with troopers from Burke to Charters Towers. You can have your fill of speeches, but the final strength is ours. Be damned to your six-shooters, your troopers and police. The sheep are growing heavy, the burr is in the fleece. Then if Lord of Belt and Gatling won't bring you to your knees, we'll find the Lord the squatters said that's made for times like these. To trial at Rockhampton, the 40 men were brought. The judge had got his orders, the squatters on the court. But for everyone was sentenced, 1,000 won't forget. When they jail a man for striking, it's a rich man's country, yet.
Well, mate, 91.
come and tell you it's going to make the rest of you bloods look sick.
Oh, ah, yeah. Yeah.
Now, you wouldn't be trying to be a ringer with me, would you?
Yeah, what's that?
You were not trying to be a ringer?
Yeah.
Yeah, you concentrated on trying to be a shearer.
Hey, Wedgie, why isn't all these boys reckoning it's such a mug with the shears?
Oh, it's just a matter of bad luck along the tracks.
Oh, yeah.
But the things I can tell you. As easily can be seen, I've sworn in both of the kids out west from the plains of the River Reed. I've sworn in most of the famous kids that I've seen big cattle down. But somehow or other, I don't know why, I never became a gun.
Oh,
reckon he's going to need more than us to handle a clip.
Yeah, well, I hear he's got another team on the way.
Oh, aye? And where might they be coming from? Would they be blacklegs now?
I don't know, but I've got my doubts.
Look, the set's been a hell of a mess. You don't know who's in the union. Who are you?
Nice,
unless they got all the earmarks, like Tom over here.
That's enough of your port, Philip, ignorant son.
Oh, you call me ignorant? You muttonhead son of a twatter!
Nobody calls me a crutch.
Come on, make it please, boy.
Lads. I wouldn't be fighting over a thing like that, though.
Now, Tomo, when you come to think about it, your Victorian has got a lot to recommend it.
After all,
where else would you find a boss of a boy like me?
A lad who takes a dozen policemen at the front.
He's not wrong, man. Now, Kelly, there's a fella could have been at the front.
That was bush ranging, Tomo. Now, what about our business, shearing? Now, I'm sure at Burrabogie. And I'm sure at Bogan Lane. I'm sure at Big Willandra and Arlen Coleraine. But before the shearing was over, I'd wish myself back again. Back here for old Tom Patterson on the 1-3 train.
Strikes for the past 4 years, and you know who won. Now, come on, the big companies have stepped down this agreement, and I've got to abide by it. Let's not fight it.
That agreement don't recognise the union.
We lost the fight, and we got kicked around, but we won't work with blacklegs.
Just right, you all are, boys. We're sharing the
news. Right. Let's get together on this, boys. Everybody's tired of fighting. Besides, your union's finished. Your bosses are in jail. Well, there's work to be done, so let's forget it, eh? Well, the important thing is I'm paying union rates. Now, what do you say? Think about it, boys, and remember this. If you don't work for me, you'll work under the same agreement elsewhere. The conditions are better here than anywhere else in the Riverina.
let's forget it, he says. Well,
Bark Alding ain't forgot. And never will be!
Yeah, all what followed. Bloody tramping up and down the country with the police at your heels, getting sick of the track. Stinking heat and flies.
Still at all, we don't work with blacklegs.
Yeah, he said to go back to work, didn't he?
Oh, on the squatter's terms.
Well, on the best terms we can get. Strike's broken, we've got to reorganise.
Yeah, I reckon that's right.
No, Joe's got a point there. Yeah.
Reorganise blacklegs, are you telling us?
Blacklegs are in the sheds, aren't they?
It's important to remember this. We didn't lose the fight. It was the layers lost it for us. Wasn't the famous said, no violence? No violence at Bark Alding. There with the redcoats. All lined up with their Gatling guns and all. No violence, to be sure. And the redcoats just standing off and shooting us down like pigeons. Aye. What are they telling us now? Hey, do the best for yourselves, they're telling us. All right. Does that mean cutting each other's throats be working non-union? If it does, you can count me out.
Yeah, they too.
That's all very well and good, mates. But we got to fight and win. It's no good us butting our heads up against the wall like a pack of billy goats. Brady said he'd pay the union rate, didn't he?
Yeah, but if we don't shear union, he'll just use them blacklegs to cut the rate.
Right.
Isn't that what caused the strike in the first place? And they smashed us. Look, the time for fighting is over. We got to rebuild from the bottom up, and the sheds have got to be organised.
I don't know who that kind of talk before. From rats. Lay off!
One in, all in. Now that's the law of the sheds.
Yep.
Maybe mother cockroach to haunt me for the rest of my days if I work with blacklegs.
Blacklegs is a word, Irish. We've got to stop thinking words of green.
Blacklegs is a thing, ass smell! You heard what Nugget said? It's the law of the sheds. One in, all in. Are you with us for that?
Well, you with the union or not? Because the union.
We ain't no union. We're the union teams, man and me. We're the union.
The union is busted. For God's sake, would you use your heads and see that?
Well, what the hell are you doing here? Why ain't you in your proud drinker to it, sir? These men and me, we know what union is. And you're no part of it.
You're not making sense, Irish. You're not making sense.
Irish?
Yes, Irish?
You should be oppressed from your working base. Get the jail, take your guns out of your cards!
You will!
Ah, to the rat of you! We're all back in the hell and all!
That's enough out of you! What are we going to do, boys?
What would you mean to be that? What do we do, indeed?
Lay off and I'll threaten you!
Stand Brody up until he doesn't agree to share union.
But Joe might be right.
Brody needs his war chest. Walk up now, he's in a fix. Right. He'll come here.
Yeah. Anyone disagree with that? Right. Then get your swags.
mean to say we're both working for the same boss?
That's right. Any objections?
Nah, of course not. Annie, why didn't you tell me last night?
Thought I'd give you a surprise. Tell me, did I?
You certainly did, but are you sure that's the real reason?
Well...
Then come on, Mary. Cross your heart, hope you die.
All right, Joe. I'll be honest with you. Thought you might not come if you knew I was here. Not for your own reasons, but so as not to embarrass me.
Yeah. You may be right. Still, I'm glad I came.
I'm glad too, Joe. So have the years been treating?
Oh, I'm not complaining. Sometimes it was hard going, and sometimes it was easy. A few things I haven't done. Driving cattle up north, and working in the sheds. But I...
But what, Joe?
I left too much of my life behind at Reedy River. Our life, Mary. Kept coming back at me, I had to do something about it. How's it been here?
Much the same. I haven't been driving or shearing. But everything came to a full stop when we broke up.
What's your old selection?
Fencing's down. Your grass is knee high. No one's touched it in all these years.
What's the house look like?
The house is all right, Joe. You see, I moved back there some time ago. It was funny that our old dog wouldn't leave. And going back there every day to feed him made me face up to things again. Then one day I went back and stayed there.
Well, wish I'd known that, Mary.
Well, whether you came back was up to you, Joe.
Well, it's the one thing I wanted. Come on. Life takes some queer twists and turns.
That's the way it got us, Joe. All twisted up.
I'll put this on the bunk.
Somehow it all seems so long ago now. Never could believe the things you believed in then. You, it was the union. Always the union. That was the start of the trouble between us. That's how it ended. That last night.
I can do with it too.
That chop paddock was hard going. Scrub was shoulder high. I had it knocked over by the time I finished.
Why break your back over it, Joe? Shearing doesn't start at Wilson's for a week yet. Well, what's on your mind? Are you worried?
Yeah, nearly.
You haven't fallen out with Wilson, have you?
Nah, it's nothing like that.
Well, what's happened?
I'm not starting with Wilson's, Mary.
But why not? The money's not bad, and God knows we need it, what with the baby coming along and all. What went wrong?
Nothing like that. Job's right any time I want it. It's just that there's trouble in the sheds up north. Big trouble.
And how does that affect us? There's been no trouble around here for some time now.
The whole country's on the rocks. Banks are going broke, bottom's falling out of the wool market, and the squatters reckon now's as good a time as any to take us on.
Oh, well, maybe they'll work out some sort of compromise. They've done it before.
Yeah, well, it takes two to do that. This time the big companies are out to smash the union by hook or by crook. It's getting pretty dirty. The kids and us are trying to start a revolution, stirring up public opinion against us and bringing in the scabs to force their hands.
Well, why do you have to be dragged into it?
It's the biggest fight we've faced. It's war. The union's calling all members to stand by a bar call. That's the battleground.
No holds barred.
And you're going?
Well, I've been in it from the start. I can't back out now. It's a testing time. For all of us.
But you can't go, Joe. Surely you see that? Look, if I didn't love you, I wouldn't feel so bad about it. But we're not doing so badly out of our bit of land and what you pick up on the side, and here you are throwing everything away. And for what? For the union?
I'm not throwing anything away. As soon as this fight's over, I'll be straight back, you'll see.
And how long will that be?
Well, the leaders reckon it shouldn't take any more than a month or so. But don't take it out on the union, Mary.
I'm not against the union, Joe. Can't say I haven't got a few hard thoughts about your leaders. I'm only asking what every woman's got a right to ask. Should her husband be around to look after her when she has a baby? Can't you see that? It's more than you and me now.
I know that. There's no need to worry. We'll win this fight in double quick time, providing no one weakens. That means me as well as the next man.
I've never stood in your way before, Joe. When it came to a strike or anything else, if you thought it was right, it was good enough for me. But this time it's different. This time I've got a right to say what you're going to do, union or no union.
If we lose this fight, they'll have us on the breadlines. They'll have scabs in the sheds from one end of the country to the other. You must see that.
All I can see right now is that your place is here with me, and not where some union leader might want to send you.
Look, you know what we're fighting for. It's for you and millions of wives like you. And their kids, and the right to a decent meal and a roof over their heads. The trouble is you've never understood that it's more than just the squatters against the shearers. Oh, damn stand-ups against us. It's crooked from start to finish, like every other bloody thing.
There's no need to curse and swear about it. Maybe I don't understand. But maybe if you're in my position, you wouldn't either. Try and see it from my point of view.
I'm sorry, Mary. You're the best wife a man can have. And I don't nap much faster. But that's the strength.
Does that mean you're going, Joe?
Hello, Mary.
So they've walked out, have they?
Well, it's a question of sharing unions.
God damn it! Don't these blokes know when they're beaten? The union's finished. When are they going to realise that?
It's just too bad.
Now we won't be able to start till late in the morning when the new blokes arrive.
They're not unions, but aren't they?
Any objections?
Yeah, plenty. Well, here just to say.
Yeah, well, we won't argue with that. What's your name?
Collins, Jay Collins.
Now I remember you came down from the Hubble Canyon way. Well, Collins, I could use an experienced man. How'd you like to be shed boss and run the shearers?
Deal.
New team will need a bit of breaking in. The last lot I had nearly butchered the sheep, not worth a Zach 100.
Now, well, I don't suppose this new lot will be any better. Did he couldn't see eye to eye with the boys on the union question?
I'm only a small man, Collins, compared to the holdings of the large finance companies, and I'm not bucking them.
Why can't you just strike with the men now to strike, say?
Well, I've got nothing against the men. I mean, I've sooner about them than the rubbish I've been getting lately. But it's not a matter of individuals, Collins. It's a question of power and who holds it.
Yeah, well, I can agree with you on that one, Mr. Brady.
Best part of my life's gone into this holding. And my father's before mine. I mean, what's a bloke to do? Shear the sheep himself. Work like a blackfella on his own property. No, Collins. I'm going to get that wool off. I'll see you right by the end of the season.
Why didn't you tell me, Joe?
What? Oh, back to work.
Yes!
Wasn't much of an opportunity. Besides, I thought you'd find out soon enough.
You thought I'd find out soon enough? And you're staying on?
Yeah, there's a job to be done.
But you went to jail for the union. You sacrificed everything. Well, I don't understand you.
Yeah, we would like to give you a chance to explain.
You've changed. Joe, I knew you wouldn't have sold out in 1,000 years.
If you just like to let me explain.
Anymore. This is no place for me.
What the hell's that supposed to mean?
I mean, sheer union or else with me too. Goodbye, Joe Collins.
Thank you.
Barney Rhodes, how are you going? Still throwing the boots out?
Hey, you tell the blokes the boss says there's going to be no more beer on the slate from now on.
Cutting out the credit, is he? Oh, very well. He ain't the only creditor we got, and he'll get his last. Reminds me of the parallel about Abraham.
Oh, he's not one of our customers.
No, no. He did his drinking a long time back. He did it off the blue too, along with a lot of other things. When his credit is caught up with him, he says, I've raised many sons to bear that burden. Real smart, brave, Red.
What a charming
stop. That's nice, isn't it?
You could have suited me at your age. Dressing for me now, though. I was never one to pretend to be what I'm not. If I'm 35, I'm 35. Well, I never would have believed it. I was just using that as an example. Oh, Mr. Dixon, how nice to see you here again.
Well, nice to see you, mum.
You are looking well.
Oh, thanks a lot.
Marvellous to see what a bit of soap and water will do for somebody.
I'd like to thank you, miss, for the tip-off.
The tip-off?
Remember? We were parked on Brodie's Run the other night. You gave us the tip to clear off.
Of course. I remember now. My warning was too late, though. You have to thank someone else for keeping your bullets out of your hand.
That's right, I remember. What did he say? Collins, I think he said his name was. I'd like to thank him for what he done.
We're precious little indeed to be thanking him for it. Begging your pardon, Mary.
Why? What's been going on around here?
There's trouble at Brodie's.
Well, that wouldn't be unusual, but how's Collins mixed up in it, huh?
We walked out on Brodie because he wouldn't cheer union. Joe Collins stayed on.
Oh, that was worse than that. Brodie made him shed moss over a bunch of blacklegs.
Well, I never would have believed it, is it? A bloke who scabs on his mates ought to be done. But isn't that what I've been saying? Yeah. Why should we stop at Collins now? It's a sin and a shame on all of us. We don't go and do the whole run, shall we?
I'm
altogether
sure that Mr. Collins isn't right. So there.
Wish I could think that way, Miss Andrews.
Indeed, and what's stopping you, Mary? I don't doubt that the shearers have a good case. But when there's work to be done, it's a shame to see able-bodied men loafing around the hotel all day.
Oh, ain't that, that's a bit rich. I mean, that place ain't been called hotel in 50 years.
It's a time for strong speaking, Mr. Tomo. I'm not unsympathetic, but the quantity of beer you men imbibe daily is frightening to contemplate. You would do your cause more credit if you drank tea.
Many minutes of the time, I've warned them of their low practices, Mum. Would you care to join me in a glass of raspberry vinegar?
Thank you.
Yeah, but that word loafer seems to come a bit too easy from some people. Yeah. Usually for them, it's don't know what our Jack even looks like.
Bush people are a mystery to her, Snowy. Don't forget, she's probably never tasted strong liquor in her life.
Sure, it's yourself that's right, Mary. And haven't I been forgetting? It was my own dear mother, God rest her soul, who was the greatest teetotaler in the county court. And why?
Because wasn't it my own dear father? Rest his soul. Who is the greatest drunkard in the county?
Well, well, look at my daddy. Hey, love. Come on, I'm pleased to see you.
Yeah, I call that
daddy. Look at my daddy. Go down the start, Bob. There's too many people.
Poor little Johnny Cash. Hoorah for the Nottingham boys and join me in a cheer. That's the place to go for an easy check. Thanks, Mum. That's the place to go for an easy check each year. When the toads get in your pocket, I borrow off a friend. Oh, isn't it nice and cozy to be camping in the bird?
Thanks, Brad.
Cheers. When me little dog flower bag sitting on the stump, me little tea and sugar bag looking nice and plump, a little fat codfish just off the hook, and four little Johnny cakes a credit to the cook. I have a loaf of bread and some Murphy's that I shook, perhaps a loaf of brownie that I snaveled off a cook. A nice leg of mutton, just a bit cut off the end. Oh, isn't it nice and jolly to be wailing in the bird? little round flour bag, sitting on the stump. Me little tea and sugar bag, looking nice and plump. A little fat codfish just off the hook. And
four little chunky cakes of bread.
Have a little book and some papers for to read. Plenty of matches and a good supply of mead.
And would it feel squatter
as beside my fire I sit with me paper in me hand and me old clay. Little round flour bag, sitting on the stump. Me little tea and sugar bag, looking nice and plump. A little fat codfish just off the hook.
And four little chubby cakes of bread to cook.
When shearing time comes, well, I'm in me glory then. I saddle up me moat and I soon secure a pen. I can't have through the blood, I gotta pull the brains. I shoot a turkey, I stick a pig, then off to camp again.
There you go, mate.
With me little round flower bag, sitting on the stump. Me little tea and sugar bag, looking nice and plump. A little fat codfish just off the hook.
And four little jolly cakes of bread.
I'm proud to be.
She's going to give us a bit of a recipe.
She's going to give us a power. Come on, me wise. Mr. Scabby Collins will be down at the pub. We have a job to be doing.
Thank you.
Count me out. What would you be meaning with that?
Count you out.
However, that's not enough English in any language, and if you don't like it, we'll go outside and settle up a thing.
Thank you indeed.
Come on, lad. Oh, sorry, man.
The Brook by Alfred Lord Tennyson. I come from haunt of coot and fern. I make a scuttling sally and sparkle out among the fern to bicker down.
Yeah, from Rose
to the
My birthday's already here, intense with a dream of joy. For every one of the routes and back with the girl dressed up as a boy.
Princess Mary. Hell's never one to say something is if it ain't, if you know what I mean.
They're after Joe, aren't they? You don't have to say anything. Come on, Rose.
If Mr. Collins has been injured, I hope you'll regret it for the rest of your life.
Reckon I better be in on it.
Let's all be in on it! Cut to the bird and bring a 50,000 car. Ta-da, he calls on it quickly.
account is a personal matter between Joe Collins and me.
Now, you're always holding things, Irish, but you've got no divine right about this one. We toss for it.
Yeah, that's fair enough. Us.
My family has always been opposed to gambling on
the... Cut out the blarney, Irish!
Us, but... All right. On this occasion, and seeing as how it's in line with me democratic outlook, all right then. Call, man.
Heads.
And heads it is.
Two out of three.
My colour.
No welting, Irish.
Now, let's be clear on one thing. It's a question of stouts, right?
Right.
All right. The ethics of a stout demand a fair go. Collins will have his chance to say what he's got to say. Then it's Snowy's turn. Understand?
Fair enough.
It's fair enough.
Yeah. What's all this fiddle-faddle about anyway? In Ireland now, we settle a little matter like this with a shillelagh. And the ethics is all straightened out afterwards.
Never mind about you. I believe a fair go.
And me too.
Come on. Let's get it over and done with.
Go on.
Who's that?
Just a few of the boys.
Oh, what do you want?
Oh, we're just after a quiet one.
Open the door and we'll open it for you.
You what?
Open the door and we'll break it through.
God! Clear off! Or I'll put a couple of buckshot into the lot of you.
Oh, if you wouldn't have made me pop pull down around your ear, you were doing the right way about it.
Shh! Is Joe? Is Joe Collins in there?
Collins got the last drop in the barrel and left half an hour ago.
Where'd he go?
Told me he was leaving the district. Now clear off or I'll let you have it through the window.
What's the strength of this?
Collins must have turned it up with Brady.
This is without rhyme or reason. First the man sells up, then walks up. This is without logic. Couldn't be happening the other way down. Bro, you needed Collins at a time like this, he wouldn't miss academic. Where's the sense in it all?
And did it ever occur to you, blokes? Maybe Joe couldn't stomach working with them black legs after all.
Oh, maybe you're right, Nugget. Well, it is more like Joe's fault. But Joe we used to know. But it's just a good penny he's gone, because I never could stick a bloke doing the wrong thing on his bikes and doing him over, I wouldn't have solved anything anyway.
Boss wants to see you.
Brody knows where he can find
you. What's he want to see us about?
He wants you back on the job.
What?
Just like I said. Brody wants you back in his shed.
What's the man after now? He knows why we walked out.
Yeah. And you can tell him from us, you little squirt. We share a union. Oh, we do it here at all.
All right, mate. Take it easy. Boss told me to tell you.
Did he agree to that?
He did?
What about the blacklegs, man? What about them now?
Looks to me like you guys got to catch up on a few things.
Where's Joe?
How have we been on that?
What have you done to him?
What have we been doing with the man?
No, you fellas came after him. What happened to him?
We haven't seen him, Rose.
Well, Joe's, he saw him here.
Well, all right, Joe Collins is gone.
Gone?
I mean, he's left the district for good.
Joe's left the district for good.
As I was saying, looks like you people got to catch up with a few things.
Oh, come on, man. Don't just stand there grinning like McGinty's goat. What's been going on up at Brody's?
Well, it was like this. When the new team started work, Brody cut the rail.
Yeah,
that's known as because of the fuel in the union. That's up you bloke didn't want to find out, by the way.
Oh, get on with it, mate.
Well, as I was saying, the next thing Brody knows, Collins has joined up the non-unionists. Hell to me. And they all stop working. Well, once more, they ain't starting up again till you blokes get back.
Looks like you blokes was a little bit too precipitous, if you ask me. Another thing.
Oh, you're all standing there patting yourselves on the back.
What about Joe?
Well, to cut a long story short, Brady and Collins had a first-class brawl over all, and Collins was fired.
Oh, it's not too bad.
Then I tell the boss to be back there, and get on the bus will be back there.
But Joe Collins goes with us.
That's right.
Okay,
well, I don't know, boss, I care about that.
All back or none.
But when you come to think of it, there ain't much Brody can do about it, is there?
No. Looks like he's going to have to stomach it.
I reckon you're right there. Well, boss wants you to report back for work in the morning. I'll be seeing you.
Well, it was a nice little fight while it lasted. And so far as John Collins is concerned, let that be a lesson to one and only one.
Let's give it the Grove. Look who's talking. You are the bloke who was screaming crook on Joe in the beginning. You just wouldn't listen when he tried to tell you something.
We've all let Joe down. Now he's gone.
Look, he can't have got far. We've horses enough to spare, so come on, what about it? Let's go. Come on.
What's a strength to you?
I reckon you shot through.
Oh, I reckon old Ballsy didn't like the idea of having his mangy pub pulled out.
Being full, Joe. Forgive me.
Yeah, I reckon she's got a few mates there. Maybe I wasn't so bright myself. And as for you fellas, I'd seen what things were like in the sheds up north, so I thought I had the wood on you.
Take a poke, Joe.
Hey?
Come on, my lad, come on to me. Take a poke.
Oh, yeah.
Well, are you coming back to the shed for the scene, Joe?
Oh, if you fellas say so.
Come on, boys.
I'm still the boss around here, and don't you forget it. So you want Joe Collins back, eh?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, well, I'll agree to that, but on one condition.
What's that?
You're a pretty tough bunch, okay? But I want a fair go from here on in.
If Joe's shed bust, you'll get it.
Yeah, that's right. That's the deal.
Yeah! Well, back to work tomorrow, fellas. And now, Mary.
How long? You know a fella always makes a speech. When there's a celebration. Begin with all creation. So,
how on fellas, it's always a thing. Bring out people, we're having a thing. Come on, let's bring out the beer. Tomorrow, boy, the quicker it's here.
Out on the ball, the old sheriff stands. For us, when it's given, and it's been funny. Yeah.
His word.
troopers and police. The sheep are growing heavy, the blood is in the face. Then if door dogs and Gatling won't bring you to your knees, we'll find the Lord the squatter said that's made for times like these. To try